Hey there, collectors, it's Big Mo here. Well, I tried. I only wanted to stick to the Iron Studios Jurassic Park line. I didn't want to get into Prime 1, but I saw some good Prime 1 vids on YouTube, and specifically I saw this one. This is a Triceratops, and they only made an EX of this, and it's only limited to 100 pieces. And I saw the vid, and I did fall in love with it. I said, oh, I'm going to see if I can find one. Believe it or not, Prime Studios still have this in stock on their website, but it does say low stock. And look at that, it's number 72 of 100. 72 is my year of birth, so I was meant to get into the Prime 1 range. So let's crack it open and have a look. All right, here's the art box, very nice. So Legacy Museum Collection, the Triceratops. So this is 1:15 scale. And this thing's heavy, it weighs 12 kilos. So I'm looking forward to getting this out of the box. Should look really nice. Triceratops is one of my favorite dinosaurs. Absolutely loved him in Jurassic Park. So yeah, let's crack it open and we'll have a look. All right. The big reveal, let's check it out. Pretty excited about this. Let's have a look. Oh, wow. Wow, look at that. Oh, that is nice. So that looks like he just comes in one piece. Looks like he's attached to the base. Well protected, which is good. We've got some, okay, it's a bit of foliage here that I'll need to put on, which is fine. And what have we got here? So this is the exclusive. This is the name board. Oh, wow, that's nice. Whew, look at that. That is huge, and that's, you could use that as a paperweight. I love that. That is really, really nice. Wow, okay. I'm keen to get it out now. So let's do that. I'll pull it out and we can have a closer look. Okay, and here it is out of the box. And all I can say is, wow. This looks amazing. I've got no idea how this hasn't sold out on Prime 1's website. Like I said, there's only 100 of these. Yeah, this looks incredible. I love the signboard. I think the signboard next to the piece just really makes it, doesn't it? You just know this is from Jurassic Park. So we'll have a bit of a close look. First of all, let's have a good look at this signboard. This is, like I said, this is huge. It's about 20 centimeters tall. Really nice concrete finish on the board. You can see, you know, some cracks there in the concrete. That Triceratops sign is 3D. Like, it's 3D. You can see there's definitely some depth to it, which looks really nice. So yeah, I love the fact that we got the signboard with this. So really, really nice. Okay, so let's have a look at this. So we'll have a look at the base first. I really like what they've done with the base. So it's a mix of, I guess, a museum piece. So a museum piece obviously normally comes with, you know, pretty like black square or round bases. But you can see they've mixed it in with dinosaur bones. So, you know, like it's underground. So I like what they've done there. Definitely multi-dimensional. See the details there, you can see some, you know, some of the dinosaur bones, which is really the, you know, that's what Jurassic Park is all about, isn't it? That was the opening scene in Jurassic Park, with Alan Grant digging for bones. So they did a really nice job with that. You can see you've got the plaque there, so Jurassic Park and then Triceratops. So the whole, I believe the whole line has that, which is really, really good. Okay, let's have a look at the paint and the sculpt and have a look at some of the details in the space. So some of these bushes I had to add, so that's one there. So you add, there's four, there's one there, you can see one at the back, and there's just two on this side as well. So one there and just that one there. So they just sort of stick in the ground. And again, it adds a nice three-dimensional look to it. You can see a bit of mud around his feet there. So obviously the ground's meant to be a bit wet. And it's got a bit of a gloss to it. Maybe it would have been nice to maybe do some puddles in the base, like Iron Studios did with their T-Rex breakout. But yeah, no, I really like it. I mean, the base is nice. See, nice big plant there on the corner. All right, let's have a good look at some of the detail here. So we'll have a look at his portrait. You tell me what you think. Actually, don't mind that. See a bit of gloss around his. See that horn there? It's got a bit of gloss where the horn meets the face, which is. It's a nice detail. He's got his mouth just slightly open and you can definitely see some gloss, like his mouth is wet inside. So that's, again, nice attention to detail that Prime might have done with this piece. We'll get in, have a good look at his eye there. Really nice. The wrinkles on his body are well done. You can see some nice scaling. I mean, if I get in there, you can see that. Some nice scaling. You can see the wrinkles, obviously, where he's bending at his knee. And same with the back here. I've gone over this piece and I cannot find a single flaw. I cannot find a paint flaw or anything wrong with this piece. See there again, see some of the scaling and the wrinkles in his joints. See some of those spots on the tail. Look at that, the way they go down the tail. Yeah, I'm blown away by this piece. I saw it on YouTube and the guy said that there's only 100 of these made and even he was surprised. So I thought, I want to jump on this. So there's only 100. I was very keen. And I've been holding off getting the Prime online. I didn't want to do it. I didn't want to get, like, sort of have two lines of the same theme. But, I'm very pleased. I'm into both now. So I get Iron Studios and Prime One, Jurassic Park and Jurassic World pieces. And you know what? They're different enough. The Iron Studios version of this has the sick Triceratops with Alan, leaning on his belly. I've got that on order too. That'll be here soon. So I think they're different enough to have both. And of course, the Iron Studios one is actually 1/10 size. This is 1/15. And this is huge. This is over 60 centimeters long for 1/15. So the Iron Studios version is going to be even bigger than this. So yeah, geez. Look, if you want one, get on Prime One's website and grab it before they're all gone. I absolutely love it. So glad that I jumped into Prime One. And I'm looking forward to getting some of their other pieces. I've got Blue on the way, 1/6 Blue. And also another Raptor, a 1/6 Raptor on the way. And I ordered their big shark from Jurassic World. That thing is going to be a monster. I can't wait to get that. So I am definitely neck deep into Prime One now. So yeah, look, I hope you really liked that. If you did, please hit subscribe, hit the like button, hit notifications. I've got most of the Prime One Jurassic Park range on order and coming. So you'll get to see all those reviews on this channel. All right, thanks for watching.